It's the 2K Sports pregame show, sponsored by Kia.
This is the NBA on 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson, happy to be here with my friends, and I mean that, my buddies, my pals, Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. Tonight, we'll be watching the Orlando Magic playing against the Washington Wizards. Last game for Washington, they picked up the W against the Hawks at Phillips Arena. A great win for them, and they rose to the occasion and pulled off the upset, riding high right now. John Wall, the clear leader on this Wizards team, does so much for him. But, Shaq, I have an idea where you're going on this other impact guy for the Wiz.
Yeah, Bradley Beal is second option on the team, and Ernie, he can produce. He also helps create plays for others with passing and spacing, and he's so good, I gave him a nickname.
Uh-oh, what is it?
The BBP.
What's BBP?
Bradley Beal Parmesan.
Oh, Parmesan. Well, like, I don't get. Oh, Beal Parmesan.
Yeah.
Instead of Veal Parmesan.
Yeah.
That's tasty.
Oh, that really is. Yeah, okay. Marcin Gortat, though. I like his game. He's a veteran inside. He provides a great inside presence. And I have a nickname for him.
Do you really?
MGP.
What would that be?
Marcin Gortat Parmesan.
Copycat.
It's time to head down to the floor and KHP, Kevin Harlan Parmesan.
what about Marcin Gortater Tot?
Gortater Tot. It's all so good.
Everyone, welcome to another exciting broadcast of the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. DA will join us tonight on the sideline. This crowd is really ready to roar in this Eastern Conference matchup for the Magic. First chance of the season for them to go up against this Wizards team. The guys, they got swept in last year's series. You know, that's the first and foremost thing in their minds as they look to turn the tables this time around.
And going back to last season, they really struggled for wins. And even against a team like this with comparable talent, they didn't manage one win in the season series.
Yeah, and you know they wanted to have a better showing against them. Maybe they can take a step in the right direction tonight, guys.
And nothing tips off a broadcast like getting the lowdown from the sidelines. And we've got David Aldridge there for that. David, good evening.
Hey, Kevin. Well, most of the attention in this year's draft has gone to Prez, but Justice Young has shown he could be the steal of the draft. Passed on by many due to his size, he has shown early that he can go toe-to-toe with any other guard in the league. And his team just raves about his work ethic and his willingness to be coached. Not bad for a player every team passed on in the first round, huh, guys?
Thank you, David. Young, just the latest steal to come as a second-round pick.
Well, guys like Draymond Green and Marc Gasol were second-rounders as well, and there are some great players in the league that were passed over early.
And one of the big issues for the Wizards is making sure they stay fiery on the defensive end. When this team, Greg, gets in trouble, more often than not, it's because they get sloppy on deep.
Yeah, and that can...
So a new group on the floor for Orlando. The Wizards also changing it up. Miami's checked in for Gortat. And Nicholson subbed in for Markieff Morris. So the Wizards five right now. The always dangerous Wall and Beal are the backcourt. Otto Porter Jr. out there with Andrew Nicholson. And it's Mahimi in at the pivot spot, manning the middle.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this league.
Quality looks they're getting, and they're capitalizing on them, guys. They have to be happy with this start offensively.
And that one's good by Porter.
Great pass. John Wall is really good at finding the open man.
Round the pass to Gordon. Young with no one around. And the three off target. Wizards trailed by four. Beal gets a wide open look. They get it back. Here's Mahimi. And it's wide right. Hits off the rim. The Magic have gone 4-7 from the field, shooting over 50%. Brown dishes to Young. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up, and two shots coming up. These teams were last season's best passers, the squads with the most assists in the NBA, the Wizards fifth.
Just a gifted passing team. They play the kind of basketball that fans love to watch. Very unselfish and fluid offensively.
First one falls for.
Boy, the Magic last season improved by 10 wins. That's nice progress for a young team, and I think they'll continue to make progress, especially at the defensive end of the floor.
Marcus Thornton, he's checked in for Washington. Burke comes in for John Wall. No problems knocking that one down. Beal's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. And Young kicks to Brown. The feed to Gordon. And that one goes in as he is fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts at the line. And for the Magic, middle of the pack defensively last season, but you think they'll continue, guys, to make strides?
Oh, I do. I think they've got too much talent not to when you look at the personnel that they have that plays at that end of the floor. And first-year head coach there, Frank Vogel, is a defense-first coach, so that'll bode well for the Magic continuing to grow and potentially, I think, be a top-10 defensive team, maybe even as soon as this season.
Beal from long range. Out of bounds, Orlando takes possession.
No clue where that pass was going. That is a brutal turnover.
Smith checked in for Nicholson. Two for one opportunity here if they want it.
And no doubt, Kevin, if I'm them, I go for it.
Here's Brown. Rebound by the Wizards. They are coming off that win against Atlanta.
They just weren't challenged. I mean, nearly as much as they should have been in that game, at least when they had the ball.
Yeah, it was a mismatch. I mean, the defense from the start was on its heels practically the entire game.
Jacks up a three, hits the three-point bomb.
Amazing shooting from Prez, a gutsy player who has no fear pulling up right away.
Burke with it. Screen by Smith. Beal from long range. The scoring fast and furious as we end the first quarter. Magic lead by six. 2K Sports, back in a moment from the Amway Center. John Wall, a multiple all-star in this league. But make no mistake, his focus is squarely on team success.
Main thing for me is going into this season is just trying to win. I mean, I got my own goal set aside that I don't talk about, but just know I got them in my head. But the main goal for everybody is just be the playoffs.
Wall's the kind of guy that has his eye on the prize all the time, and the less emphasis he places on his own goals, I think, Greg, the better he seems to get.
That's great.
So both teams making some changes here. So it's the Wizards now, trailing by five. Taking a look at the Wizards. They've got Bradley Beal. Gortat is out there with Andrew Nicholson, and it's Wall, and it's Thornton in at the two. And so it looks like the Wizards will retain possession here.
Risky pass in a situation like that. Very lucky that wasn't a steal.
Fortunate to get it through. I thought he was headed the other way with that one.
Beal from long range. No good that time.
Not sure why he keeps trying his luck from deep here. It's just not his night. And one of the things I love about Bradley Beal is he is a consistent shooter of the deep ball. I mean, always seems to hover around that 40% mark from beyond the arc. And ever since he's come into the league, that has been the case. And he's also improving in the other areas in terms of his ability to attack and get to the rim and playmaking. The only question for me is, can he find a level of consistency in terms of his health? That's been the only detriment to his game.
It's Brown with the drive. Gortat comes up with the rebound. Washington has gotten into trouble with the three ball in the second quarter, only hitting one of five attempts. Wall kicks to Thornton.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Young. Now let's take a look at how the shots have been divided up between three-point shots and two-point shots for Washington. .115 left in the first half of basketball. Here's Beal, and it's blocked by Ibaka.
And well, he's been the NBA's leader in blocks multiple times. Ibaka just has that rare instinct for it.
Down low. And look at Prez there, just punishing the rim.
Wow. And you love the ferocity that Prez finished that playoff with. No layups for the big fella.
Ball passes to Nicholson. 44 seconds left here in the second. Here's Beal. That shot is off. And Orlando will come the other way. Outplayed in the previous game on their schedule, losing to Sacramento.
And really, given how they performed offensively, guys, they just never had a chance.
Yeah, and you can see their frustration growing and growing as they continued to come up empty on their possessions. By the end, they were just happy to watch the clock wind down and move on.
The Magic making a switch here. Biombo's checked in.
And they have yet to miss a shot from the line here this quarter.
Yeah, you have to make teams pay for fouling you. That's why they call them free. And they've done exactly that, made them pay.
Brown against Beal. Marcus Thornton on the wing. A three-pointer is right on target. Thornton's got his first 3 points of the game.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agenda.
Yeah, and it's really fun to see that kind of unselfishness. Really hard not to appreciate all the assists they've racked up.
Yeah, and there it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great inside position.
Young's not going to give you anything easy. I mean, he's really good at crowding shooters and challenging shots.
And we're through the first half of basketball.
Kevin, thank you. Aaron, you all have played at a high level so far. What has worked for you?
We're just sticking to the game plan. You know, our coaches really drew up something good for us. You know, they wrote it out, and we're sticking to it, and we're executing very well.
Yeah, that's obvious the way you all have played. Thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
Nice work, but we can still improve. Take a seat. Hey, if we let up on D, even...
We're back with you in Orlando, where you can see some of the street art that adorns this beautiful city. And now, the start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters. Nice game, great performance by Prez.
Yeah, created a lot of quality shots for himself in that first half, and he knew when to pass it up when the double team came.
And that led to a very high points per shot number for him. For those of you that are into analytics, that stat really tells how efficient a player has been, and he's been very efficient so far.
Washington making some changes. Smith checked in for Gortat. Nicholson comes in for Markieff Morris. And Trey Burke subbed in for John Wall. Brown, he's in at three. Hezonja is out there with Young. Then it's Aaron Gordon, and it's Biombo at the five. That's who's out there for Orlando.
And Mario Hezonja, the fifth overall pick in 2015 out of Croatia. He's played pro basketball from the time he was a teenager, competing in the second best league in the world since age 17. That'll get you ready for the NBA.
Four on the clock. Let's it fly. And the shot falls short this time. Orlando leading. Unloads. Not wasting any time and taking the shot and knocking it down. Hezonja's got seven. Wizards have gone 5 of 12 from the field since the third quarter got underway. And Hezonja was regarded as maybe the cockiest player in his draft class. The guy's tremendously confident.
Yeah, and nothing wrong with that when you're a sniper. You love to see shooters not have any fear and have great confidence and no conscience when it comes to launching them from three-point range. So That assassin's mentality and bravado, that's what you want in a shooter.
You know, one of the basic fundamentals in basketball is the ability to box out. He's got that down pat.
Smith dishes to Burke. He kicks to Nicholson. To the inside. The Wizards working the ball around now. Burke, the pass to Porter. Offline with his three. Orlando's gone 1-of-4 in three-point shots here in the third. And the pass to Biombo. Here's Azania. He's covered by Beal. Young outside. And the release was before the buzzer, but it's off target. And at the close of the third quarter, still a close game, and both teams putting up points in a hurry. Magic lead by two. Don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be back in just a moment. And thanks for joining us again as the fourth quarter of play is set to get rolling. It's been 12 seconds left to play in the final quarter. So on the floor for Washington, Wall and Beal, the incredible backcourt tandem. Jason Smith is out there with Markieff Morris, and it's Mahimi in at the five roaming the paint. And they foul intentionally. They're going to have to do that now again and again. They're not in the penalty yet.
That's right. No other option but to foul and hope for some misses.
Yeah, they have to extend the game. I mean, plain and simple. Use every second you can on the clock here.
And they go to the intentional foul. And he misses the first one. Boy, he wanted that one to fall.
And Prez is just brilliant. Just has such remarkable initiative and moves well without the ball.
Washington calls timeout. They trail by...
Listen, guys, we've got one guy doing all the damn...
quarter. Guys, what do you think?
Let's face it, really difficult to find an open three in this situation. Look, there's no secret. It's the only shot that'll save him. So the D is...
Got it! Got it! What a shot!
And that, guys, that's one for the highlight reel. They needed a three to extend the game, and the young fella delivers.
Yes, he did. A clutch shot, and really what I like, guys, there was no hesitation. He shot it freely and with confidence. As a result, we're headed to overtime.
Well, if you love great competition and neck-and-neck basketball action, this one has been a great one. Overtime number one, getting going right now. Tip-off goes to Orlando. And so they have the first opportunity on offense right here as we begin overtime. Courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineup for us now in overtime. On the court for Orlando... Brown in at small forward. Aaron Gordon out there with Bismack Biyombo. And it's Young, and it's Hezonja in at the two spot. Beal can't get it to go.
And he rushed that one, no doubt about it. The D out of position, you could see the frustration on his face.
And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two.
Tell you what, that remarkable foot speed of Gordon's really causes problems for the defense. He's a hard guy to keep in front of.
Vucevic. And so it's Washington who scraped by with the win. A double overtime game can really take its toll on the players, and after this one, the officials, the fans, everyone's going to have to take a needed rest.
No doubt. I mean, when you have to dig that deep and play with that much determination to get a win, it was earned, and I tell you what, they've got to feel really good about themselves for fighting through.
Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA on 2K Sports. We'll see you next time.
That hurts, man.
I mean, I would rather get blown out by 50, right?
Last second.
depressed. How you feeling?
Terrible, man. I'm playing frustrated. I'm playing scared. I'm playing, like, weak out there.
It's mental. I'm telling you.
Yeah, I mean, I know it's mental. I just don't know what the block is, man. I don't know how to get out of it.
Well, I could tell you're thinking about dominating every night.
Of course.
Well, try thinking about something else.
Like
the birds, cooking shows, the zombie apocalypse.
The birds?
It doesn't matter.
Wait, you serious right
now?
Yeah,
man. I'm telling you, it's a zen thing. You know, like, you're natural at basketball, right? But the more you think about it, it becomes unnatural. All right? You got to get back to thinking about nothing so you can just react on the court.
I like that, man. I'm going to try that.
Yeah?
That's what you do?
Yeah. I try to think about, like, old songs, like Motown. Mm-hmm. And, like, those type of lyrics just come to me when I'm just, like, balling.
Yeah. Like what?
Like, how I wish it would rain.
What is going on with you?
I don't know, Mom. Look, it's a long season, you know? I'm just trying to figure out how to work through it.
Your body language is all off.
Wait, you can see that?
Well, I have high-definition TV. I better be able to see it.
Dang. Well, I didn't know anybody could see it. That's not what I'm trying to do.
Well, just work through it. Don't try to force, because then you'll just get frustrated.
Yeah, but I feel like I gotta push through it, Mom. I mean, that's the only way I'm gonna get better.
What I mean is, it's okay to have a bad stretch at times. Don't beat yourself up over it.
Yeah, I'll try.
Look, you know you're better than you've been playing. Just let the averages work out. You'll be back to you in no time.
You're right. But thanks, Mom. Oh, by the way, look, you don't have to send any more food. I got plenty of stuff here.
Okay. Well, let me know when you need some more.
You know I will. Love you, Mom.
Love you, baby. Bye-bye.
Bye.